Good morning. Good morning. If you're alive and you're living, good morning. I want to hear your voice. All right. So the bio was quite impressive, but I don't think I'm all of that. But okay. So I speak my talk this morning alongside my other speaker. That was an amazing session, by the way. Please come put our hands together for. Thank you. I had to tweak my session a little bit because I had to, you know, take a step back, you know, walking into APSU this morning, and I remember I had like some level of flashbacks. I studied here, by the way. I studied biochemistry class of 2019. And by the grace of God, well, so I'm going to speak in on the topic, like, the newbie's guide to starting strong. So, by show of hands, are you a designer, you're a software engineer, you're a graphic designer, you're a project manager, product manager of any sort? Can you wave your hands? All right. Okay. If you are enthusiastic, you'd like to, you don't know what tech is, but you're in tech, but you'd like to get into tech, can you wave your hands? Anybody? Tech money in the world? Okay. Thank you. All right, so I'd like to introduce myself a little bit. My name is Christian Nnabugwu. I am a software engineer and UX designer, but I like to think of myself as a multidisciplinary designer. I've been doing this by the grace of God for the past 8 years. I am currently leading the team of design and product innovation at Lloydant Business Services. I think Lloydant Business Services is the lead ICT client for Abia State University. So, plus or minus, you should know who we are. So, why tech? A lot of people, you know, you've heard talks, you hear a lot of people, you know, say a lot of things about tech. You know, it's where, it's the next oil money in Africa, it's the next oil money in Nigeria. A lot of people have different reasons why they would love to get into tech. So, but I'd like to streamline that a little bit and give you an idea. Please, I will need you to pay attention. Don't mind the door. I want your eyes up here, right? This is very important. It is something that has changed my life, something that I'm quite passionate about. Like I said, I studied biochemistry at Abia State University here. BBCM student, hi. BBCM student, okay. Yeah, started that, led the prayer. So I studied biochemistry. Nothing related to software engineering, nothing related to coding, nothing related to any of the things that I'm doing now. So this is something that has transformed my life and has brought me this far. And if you're interested, it can also change your life as well. So number one reason is that it is a growing industry. As a matter of fact, it is something that has grown so big. It's just spreading like wildfire. Every single thing that has to do with our lives, who we are, who we're going to be in the next future is highly dependent on technology. So there are a lot of, it's an emerging market, ever developing market. So it is very accommodating, has nothing to do with what you studied in school, but heavily dependent on what you can do. So there's a high demand for software engineers, for product developers, for product managers, UI UX designers, and the rest of them. So it is also something that you and I can take a part of. So I'd like to break down, just in case you are interested in, you know, getting into tech, just in case it's something you'd like to try out, I'd like to give you a little roadmap, you know, how I got to where I am now and how you yourself can also get into what's happening. So the first is key tech. We have key tech areas in software development, data science, cybersecurity, UI UX design, and all of that. But I'd like to say tech is divided into two, right? There are no code tech skills, and there are code-based tech skills. So as the name implies, code-based tech skills are skills that require, you know, a heavy amount of coding. It means you have to be a software engineer, software developer, cybersecurity expert, and all of that. But no code-based tech niche in tech, as it were, are tech roles that require little to no coding. So you're talking about product management, you're talking about business analysis, talking about product design or UI UX, called it, talking about graphic design, and so on. Sorry, I don't know what I meant. Okay, right. So it is quite important for us as very young people to begin to get into tech, because if you go to countries like Dubai, China, the UK, and all of these first world countries, you will see that the leading people at the forefront of what's happening in technology today are young people like you and I. So if you've used ChatGPT here, can I see your hands? Right. If you don't know how to use ChatGPT, can I see your hands? Can I look at your neighbor to confirm? Oh, wow. Right. Okay. So you should learn how to use ChatGPT. So it is, like I said, it is an evolving market. It is quite important, quite open, right? Easy barrier, easy breaking level barriers for us to enter. So a lot of skills that you can pick up if you decide to go through the path of software engineering or UI UX design and the rest of them. So you're talking about coding skills, problem solving skills, and critical thinking. Now, a lot of people go to buy courses online. Courses are kind of like an accelerator, but doesn't necessarily mean whether you decide to become a software engineer or a UI UX designer. So I'm gonna go to the next slide. So I'm gonna talk about some learning resources. So like I said, buying courses more or less will not do so much for you. I stand to be corrected. But buying courses will not do so much for you. You need a one-on-one interaction with an instructor, somebody who has been in the game for a while, and somebody that can instruct, that can hold your hands all the way to the end, right? So this outlined here are some of the resources I feel like you can take, just in case you'd like to take courses or try courses on Coursera, Udemy, Khan Academy, and the rest of them. Then for coding bootcamps are what I would personally recommend. Personally went through one. So there's Andela, Lambda School, Learnable by Tennessee. So I did Learnable a couple of years back, and it's kind of like strengthened my foundation when it has to do with software engineering and UI UX design. Then for community resources, you want places where, you know, there are people who are already in the game, you know, daily committing, daily, you know, changing the knowledge, changing the information that you can find that can help you grow. So we're talking about places like Free Code Camp, GitHub, and the rest of them. Now, the next step in your journey into becoming into tech would be building a portfolio. So I don't know how many of you that know that you can actually get remote jobs outside the country. I'm not talking about Nigerian remote jobs, but jobs that can pay you in dollars as a student. How many people? All right. So I'm a beneficiary of that, currently a beneficiary of that, right? So the first step in for you as a person trying to get to tech is to build a portfolio. It is the way your recruiting managers and the rest of the people that who are interested in your services will know that you are capable of doing what you say you know how to do, right? And it is quite important, because that is the way you showcase your work. That is the way you prove that, okay, this is, I am a software engineer, I've built X, Y, Z, and this is how my process goes. I'm a product manager, I've seen so and so products, these are links to those products, and all of those things. So, if you're a software engineer, if you write code, yeah, please can you wave your hands? Okay, so then you should be familiar with GitHub, right? Yes. So GitHub is kind of like your own online-based portfolio that you can send to recruiters or recruiting managers. You can also create a personal website and keep it updated, right? So I don't necessarily have a website. So I do design, both UI UX design, graphic design, and all of those things that has to do with design as it were. So my portfolio, when I started, was on Behance. How many of us know what Behance is here? Right. So Behance is, you know, and great place to start. You can also use Dribbble as well. There are also, you know, free free no-code-based platforms that you can also use to host your personal website. There are templates. You can edit them that will allow you to also host your own portfolio. Now, networking and mentorship. So I got into where I'm working currently by somebody that knows somebody that knows somebody that knows somebody. But it started with one somebody. And I'd like to tell you that, you know, yes, the traditional application, you writing your resume, sending in your cover letters to companies to hire you, still works, but doesn't work so much because when we have a high level of unemployment rate, you now have more than 1,000 people or 3,000 people struggling for the same position as you. And one of the ways to, you know, have a strong networking, you know, opportunities is basically to use platforms like LinkedIn. How many of us know LinkedIn? Right. So a lot of people just go there to just catch gist, but you don't know that you can actually use those platforms to network. Now, gaining experience. You know, it's one thing to say, okay, I'm going to start this. You know, you pay for the course, you learn for a while, and then, you know, there are a lot of things that are quite confusing. You build for a while, right? But there's when you go on job platforms like LinkedIn again, right, and you see, oh, we need somebody with XYZ years of experience, and you're just looking at yourself, you feel like you've not really gotten that opportunity. So one of the best ways to actually begin to get experience is internships. You know, apply for internships. Internships sometimes can be paid, sometimes they cannot be paid. But that is the fastest way to actually break into the industry, to gain experience when you're getting your hands dirty and getting a job. That was the first way I got that same opportunity. Then freelancing platforms. If you use Upwork here, wave your hands. Fiverr, right? All right, good. So freelancing platforms are also another way for you to actually build a body of work, right? You build something, clients, you know, pay you to do X, Y, Z of work, and then you have to actually add it to your portfolio to actually show that you know how to do what you say you know how to do, right? And then we have local tech hubs, right? Around, I don't know if there are any tech communities. Is there GDG at the State University, Google Developers Group? Is there one? All right, yeah, beautiful. So that is also another way of building experience, right? Joining communities like that allows you to actually build things with other people. Now, doing all of these things, sometimes it is easy, right, to get demotivated. You know, you've done tech for a while and you've not seen or probably picked anything or, you know, gotten any serious clients, or probably you've sent 1,000 applications to a lot of, you know, companies, and then you're not getting any feedback, right? So I want to talk about some realistic ways that you can actually help yourself to stay motivated and keep pushing. So the first one is setting realistic goals and tracking your progress, right? So most times a lot of people think, oh, if I start now, next 4 months, I'll finish learning HTML and CSS, and then I will just apply and I will get a job somewhere and I will be paid in billions of dollars. But sometimes, as we will always find, that this is not necessarily the case. So you have to set realistic goals. What can you do now? How can you do it? And how can you keep up? Right? You celebrate your small wins. Maybe you pushed, successfully wrote your first Hello World. Right? You celebrate your small wins. The next is to learn from failures and persist. You've tried, keep trying. You've tried, and it doesn't work out, keep pushing. Then my own personal story. So I really hope, I'm gonna tell that maybe at the end of my talk. All right. So my own personal story, I studied biochemistry in Abia State University, 2018, 2019. I was about to write my final year papers here. I was currently a graphic designer. I've done a little bit of things here and there in tech, but I was still trying to figure or find my place in the world. So I had a lot of, you know, setbacks, right? I have had a lot of, you know, soul searching, trying to figure out what direction I can take, what direction would take me, because there was a lot of anxiety. How many of us are in final year here? All right. So how many of us are approaching final year? You're not in final year yet, but you're approaching final year. Okay, beautiful. So you're going to come to that point where you have a lot of questions. And most times you may not have anybody there to answer those questions. On my own end, I was fortunate to have a mentor who is a senior person at Bank Group. So we had a lot of back and forth, and I prayed about it. And then I decided to just try software engineering and see what it was about. So when I went for my service here, and I had gotten to Enugu, and for some reason I was still searching for a place or primary assignment, your PPA. I kept praying about it, and I talked about a couple of things before. I reached out to somebody. I reached out to a lot of people, but somebody I talked to somebody that gave me the opportunity that led me here. So why I had to share that short story is basically because I know a lot of us are going to have or are going to come to that point where you're going to ask yourself some very foundational questions. And it is very important that you know that, yes, you can actually reach out to people that are higher than you, that you know that this, you know, coming to this point where I am now, and probably higher, is actually quite possible. And now here is something I've always wanted to. Thanks for coming to my TED Talk. Okay, that was an answer.